So everyone, please quickly join me for the session. Yes. So I can see we have, please everyone, those who are in the YouTube and in the app, please confirm me whether I'm audible or not. So hi, Tarak Sai, Bosetti and Chandan Paswan, good evening, welcome to the session. Hi, Sahithi Bushi and Kamlesh Kumar, very good evening. Welcome to the session. Please everyone, those who have joined me in the YouTube and in the app, please tell me whether I'm audible or not. I'm audible, please tell me everyone. So my dear students, a very important information to all of you. Yes, after a very long time waiting from the month of March, and now it's we can say July, 11th of July, the recruitment for the BARC scientific officer is out now. And guys who are waiting for such a long time for this very important exam, now your waiting time is over, absolutely over. Now I will tell you the entire information for how you can become a scientific officer in the Bhabha Atomic Research Center. So very, very good evening all of you, my dear students. Narendra, Sahil Gupta, Aragam Reddy, and Bablu, Tarak Sai, Narendra, Ravi Teja. Okay, I'm audible. Okay, all right. So those who are there in the YouTube channel, please do not forget to like and share the session, my dear students. Please share this session to all your friends who are waiting so eagerly for the BARC examination, my dear. BARC 2021 recruitment for scientific officer. Now the notice is out now. Those who are waiting for this exam, my dear students, now your waiting time is over. Now I will be telling you the entire information for this, how you can apply for the BARC exam with and without gate. Yes, everyone. Hi, Robin Richard. Good evening. Welcome to the session. Request everyone, those who are there in the YouTube channel, please do not forget to like and share the session. Those who are in the app, Kamlesh Kumar, Saiti, and Ven, Melar, Lakshya. Very good evening, everyone. Welcome to the session. BARC test series, I'm telling you that we are going to launch a very short course also for this BARC. Okay. GradeUp will be launching not only a test series but also a course, so that you can prepare. Those who are going to do the write the written examination for the BARC will be also launching a course for you, and that I will also share you today. Okay, so let's begin the session, my dear students, without waiting. And so here's a small description about me. I'm Vikas Bhagwari, and that is all basic details about myself. So my dear students, let's come directly on the important points that you are waiting for a long, very long time, my dear students. And those who will follow me for this session, please do not forget to like and share the session also. And if you have not subscribed to our YouTube channel, please do subscribe it. So the important date, the online application process for OCES DGFS 2021 for the BARC recruitment is started, and this commencement means starting will be on 12th of July. That is tomorrow onwards. Today is 11th of July. Maybe in tonight midnight only it will. The recruitment process is going to start. The online application process will start from tonight only, maybe after 12 a.m. or maybe by tomorrow. Okay, so tomorrow onwards you can start filling the application form for BARC. Okay, last date for registration of the online application is 7th of August, and last date for submission of the online application is 9th of August. Yes, please take care of the dates also. These dates are very, very important. Okay, because you have been waiting for this exam for a very long time. So if you forget to fill the form on the exact date, then obviously then you have to wait for the next year. So please do not forget to fill your form by these end dates. The last date for submission of online application is 9th, and registration is 7th August. All right. Online exam, online examination slot booking date is from 20th August to 25th August. You can book your examination slot in that time period. Online examination will be on 5th of September to 12th of September. Yes, the time is not that much less now. So very less time is left. Yes, final year students will be eligible for this exam. So you don't have to worry about it. Okay, Navdeep. Display of the list of the candidates shortlisted for the interview on online application portal, that will be on 21st of September. Those who will be selected for the interview, the list of the candidates will be displayed on 21st of September. So each and every important dates I'm telling you, my dear students, you guys have to do one thing. You have to share and like the session. Come on, guys. Can you provide notification link here? See, notification link you can download from the internet. And I think our team will also provide the notification link in the description of this video. Okay. Maybe you will get the entire notification links in the description of the video. The PDF will be provided there only. Alright. Also, I will share the entire notification. I will share the entire PDF in my Telegram channel after the session. Alright. Availability based on the online application portal to select the interview slot. You can also select the interview slot in this time period from 24th of September to 28th of September. You can basically book the interview slot for the online application. Okay. And selection interview will be on 4th of October to 29th October. That will be a time for the interview for the bar. Okay. Display of the list of the candidates finally selected for OCES on online application portal is 2nd week of November 2021. And last date on for selected OCS candidate will be basically, that means you know that after you get select in this bar, you have got two options. First option is either you can continue to work or you can also go for the M.Tech. If you want to do your M.Tech, you can also pursue your M.Tech from the colleges which are attached with that. Okay, that last date will be 3rd week of November. If you want to opt for the M.Tech opportunities for the colleges which are basically linked through the BARC recruitment, you can basically apply for the M.Tech also. Declaration of the list of the applications selected for DGFS. What is OCS and DGFS? I will also tell you that. That is the last date is 30th of November. Okay, so I will tell you everything. So my dear students, in the BARC, there are two training schemes and employment description. BARC training schools provides two training schemes to deserving candidates ambitious of pursuing a rewarding career in the nuclear science, energy and technology. Okay, so these basically are of two types. Alright, first is orientation course for engineering graduates and science postgraduate, that is called OCES. Second is called as DAE, graduate fellowship scheme for engineering graduate and physics graduate, that is called DGFS. So one is called as OCES, one is called DGFS. Successful completion of the training schemes guarantees the employment as scientific officer C in one of the DA units of Atomic Energy Regulation Board with attractive career progression. Okay, so these are the two types of basically trainings that we provide that they provide in BARC. One is called OCES, that is orientation course for engineering graduates and science postgraduates, and another is called DGFS. Okay, now let's talk about the OCS, 1 year orientation course. This OCS is for 1 year. It is a 1 year orientation course in the BARC. Okay, and that is basically for 2021-2022. It will be conducted at the 5 BARC training schools situated at Mumbai, Kalpakkam, Indore and Hyderabad. Okay, and I have also attached the tables 1 and table B where the eligible discipline, what are the branches which are eligible. I will tell you everything, my dear, in this session. What are the branches which are eligible for the BARC? I will tell you everything. And I will also tell you the eligibility, discipline and orientation training program in each of the training schools. Okay. Successful training. After training program, a trainee as scientific officer will be posted as scientific officer in following DA units. Okay. That is Bhabha Atomic Research Center, you will be posted. Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research, Kalpakkam. Or Raja Ramanna Center for Advanced Technology, Indore. Or maybe Heavy Water Board, Mumbai. Or Nuclear Fuel Complex, Hyderabad. So these are the center where you can get posted after your successful training. Okay, that training will be of 1 year. These are the different centers given here. Board of Radiation Isotope Technology, Mumbai. Nuclear Power Corporation of India, Mumbai. Bharati Nabikya Vidyut Limited, Kalpakkam. Okay, Uranium Corporation, Jadugudha. Okay, these are the centers where you will get posted. Appointment in the DA, it is Department of Atomic Energy. Units shall be as Group A Gazetted Officer of the Government of India, except in Bhavani, NPCIL and UCIL, which are governed by Service Rules of Corporation. Okay. Yes, the opportunities for all the branches. I will tell you the opportunity, whether that opportunity is for computer science or not. I will share everything. Just be with me till the for the next few seconds. And to those who have not liked this session, please do not forget to like and share it also. Very good evening to everyone, those who have joined me in the GradeUp app. Abhishek, Rahul, Fabin, Lakshya, very good evening, my dear students. So, my dear students, the trainee scientific officer who have completed their training, they will be who have successfully completed the training program and whose performance meets a minimum eligibility criteria, they are allowed to enroll for M.Tech, M.Phil in Homi Bhabha National Institute. After your completion training, you will be also given an opportunity to apply for the M.Tech or M.Phil, that is Master of Philosophy or Master of Technology for program in the HBNI. It is a deemed university of Bhabha Atomic Research Center, that is called Homi Bhabha National Institute. Okay, these those not desire who are not desiring of pursuing M.Tech, they are entitled to a postgraduate diploma of this Homi Bhabha National Institute, provided their academic performance is above a specific threshold. So either you can opt for the M.Tech of 2 year, or you can basically apply for the basically we can say that a postgraduate diploma program in HBNI. Second option is called 2 year DAE, that is called DAE Graduate Fellowship Scheme for Engineering Graduate and Physics Postgraduate, that is called as DGFS. So one is called OCS, one is called DGFS. Under this scheme, engineering graduates and physics postgraduate who have excelled in the selection interview for the BARC training school program and have also independently secured admission for M.Tech and all these institutes are paid stipend and tuition fee to pursue M.Tech while retaining their employment in DAE. So while you are employed, you can also have a chance for your pursuing your M.Tech. Okay. So this DGFS is for 2 year, OCS is for 1 year training. Okay. After successful completion of 1 year coursework at the institute, DGFS fellow undertake the project work which is assigned by Department of Atomic Energy and supervised jointly by DAE Institute Guide. Alright. And after that, you will be posted at Group A Gazetted Officer of the Government of India after completion of your training. On joining, they are required to first undertake a 4-month orientation course for DGFS fellow at the BARC Training School, Mumbai. Alright. That is all. Now let's talk about the stipend and allowances during the training. When you will be in the training, you will be having the allowances OCES, that is OCES Trainee Scientific Officer and DGFS Fellow. They will be provided with a stipend of 55,000 per month. Okay. During the period of their training and a one-time booking allowance of 18,000. DGFS Fellow are reimbursed a tuition fee for M.Tech. And you just have to pay additional, and additionally you will be paid a one-time contingency grant of 25,000 to meet M.Tech project-related expenses. Okay, boarding and lodging in DAE hostel is mandatory for the OCS trainee scientific officer during the training period, and all that. Selected candidates are required to execute an agreement and a personal indemnity bond. So after you get selected in this, you have to fill a bond of to serve Department of Atomic Energy at least for 3 years after completion of training. You have to fill a bond, and that bond is of 6,78,000 for OCS Trainee Scientific Officer and 13,58,000 bond for DGFS Fellow. Okay, so that bond is also there if you have to work for at least 3 years. If you don't work for 3 years, you have to pay that bond money. Now, if we talk about the grade and pay scale of appointment after successful training of training program in all units shall be as a scientific officer C. Okay, you will be posted as a scientific officer C in the level 10. And your salary will be 56,000 according to 7th Central Pay Commission by pay metrics. And after you add all these DNS alliance, that is DA, house rent alliance and transport alliance, your monthly salary will be around 95,000. As per the Mumbai rate, which is a metro city, your monthly salary will be around 95,000. So we can say approximately you will get 95,000. Okay. In addition, other allowances such as leave travel concession by air every year up to first 8 year, and once in 2 years thereafter, children education allowance and all that, you will be getting all that. Okay. So this will be the salary that you'll be getting if you are in a metro city like Mumbai. All right. Now let's talk about the selection process. What is the eligibility criteria? No. It is not in hand, my dear. Obviously, you have to give some tax also, but monthly after with three increments, you can say that my monthly salary will be around 95,000 after three increments. Starting salary will be 56,100. After that, you will be 95,000. All right. Now, what is the selection process? Process for that selection to the OCS DGFS is a two-step process. Firstly, the screening to the shortlisted candidate followed by selection interview. See. You can apply for this by two ways. Eligibility criteria batao. See, I will be telling you everything, my dear. Please, those who have joined me for this session, please first of all like the session. 61 students are like, but no, only 37 likes. So please everyone quickly like the session and share the session. Selection process, there is a separate selection process for each of the discipline listed in the table 1 and 1B except for code 30 and 31 and all that. So let me come directly on that. Selection screening for the selection interview. The number of vacancies have not been mentioned yet. Okay, they have not mentioned the number of vacancy in the admission brochure, in that brochure, but they will be normal vacancy like they used to be. They have not right now, they have not disclosed the number of vacancy yet. Okay, so screening for the selection interview based on the two methods. One is called as on the basis of online examination. Online examination will be conducted on September 21. Okay, so you can apply for this. You can apply for the BARC examination based on the written examination, or you can directly apply based on your GATE score. Okay, so online examination, online written examination for the BARC will be conducted in the month of September. In the beginning of the session, I have told you all the important dates. For all the 9 engineering disciplines, I will tell you what are the engineering disciplines eligible for that. Many of the students are asking what are the branches which are eligible. Okay, for 9 engineering disciplines and 4 science disciplines in more than 40 cities spread across India. Travel allowance is not paid for appearing in it. You will not be given any travel allowance. Thank you, my dear Aditya. I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you, my dear. Candidates who register for the online examination will be permitted to book an examination slot in examination center based on the availability in the August. So if you are selected for the written examination, you have to book your examination center also, which city you want to apply for. All the candidates appearing on the BARC online examination will be awarded a BARC online examination score as per the methodology or outlined in Annexure 1. Shortlisting of these candidates for selection interview will be based on the online examination score. Okay. Second method of applying for the interview will be on the basis of your GATE score. That is the GATE 2021 score. Candidates will be screened for selection interview on the basis of a valid GATE 2022, 2020 or 2021 score. So whether you can apply based on your GATE 2020 score or GATE 2021 score in the applicable GATE subject. Applicants with a degree in nuclear engineering will be screened in only on the basis of online examination to be conducted. Okay. See, Tarak, you can apply for both. You can choose both the options. If you have got a rank of 906, yeah, you can. If in general category, if you have got a rank of 906, you can definitely apply for the BARC interview, and you can also apply for the written. See, written application fee is just 500 rupees. So you don't have to pay much for the written examination. So you will be having both the options in your hand. Okay, it's not that if you see, if you get a call based on your GATE score, you can apply for the interview. You don't have to go for the written examination. But if you are not getting a call based on your GATE score, you can at least you will be having second opportunity of writing the written exam, right? So it will be nice in third year. No, third year students are not eligible for the written examination. It is only for final year. Okay. At the time of the application, candidates can choose any one or both of the above screening option. When you apply for the this BARC application form, you can choose both the options. You can choose both the option, my dear. One more thing, what is the level of written examination? Level will be exactly like the GATE level. Okay, the question will be GATE level. In the BARC exam, questions are exactly like GATE level questions. At the time of the application, candidates can choose any of the options. Okay. As a cutoff, GATE score for the screening into selection interview will be finalized only after conclusion of the online examination. Candidates are advised to maximize their chance of being screened to the selection interview by availing both the screening options. See, it is a suggestion given in the BARC application brochure only that you should choose both the options. It will be better for you to choose both the options because you don't know whether you will be called for the interview based on your GATE score. If you are having very good GATE score, below 500, you will be having 100% chance. But let's say you are not having good score and you are not called for the interview and you have not chosen the second option of written examination. So then you have to wait for the next year for written examination of BARC. So better will be to choose both the options. Okay, clear everyone? Candidates who opt for the screening through online examination will be permitted to book an examination slot at a center of their choice. Okay. Geologists are eligible. I will talk. I will see that whether geologists are eligible or not. Okay. Candidates who opt for the screening through online examination will be permitted to book an examination slot at a center of their choice, subject to availability. Alerts by email as well as SMS will be sent to candidates who have opted for online examination. So you have to check your mobile phone. You will be provided the alert for the notification. That notification may come either through mail or SMS that whether you have got. If you have examination center, okay, regarding the availability of examination center, you will get a alert from email or SMS. So you have to provide a valid email or SMS. See, CSE is eligible or not, I will just tell you. Just wait for a few seconds. Okay, I will tell you everything. Examination on the registered email address and mobile number as well as announced on this website. Examination slot will be allocated on the first come first serve basis subject to availability. My dear students, the application form last date is 9th August and after that you have to apply for the examination center where you want to book the examination center. So if you want to get an examination center of your choice, then it will be better if you fill it as soon as possible. Okay, as soon as the dates of examination center filling choice is open, just fill it. Otherwise, you will not be able to get the first option of your choice. Okay, candidates are advised to visit the website regularly for update regarding this. Candidates who have opted for screening only on the basis of a GATE score will not be allotted examination slot for the online examination. If you have only applied for the selection interview based on GATE score, then you will not be given option to write the online examination. Only those who have opted for both the options will be allowed to appear for the interview based on GATE score as well as based on written examination. Okay. One more thing, that student graduated with a master degree from University of Mumbai Department of Atomic Energy for Excellence in Basic Sciences and National Institute of Science Education. Agar aap mein se inme se koi hai and you are having a CGPA of 7.5 on a scale of 10 from these colleges of National Institute of Science Education and Research, Bhubaneswar, or you are from master degree from University of Mumbai, then you can directly apply for the interview. Don't have to fill for the application form. Okay, you don't have to book for the online examination. Selection interview of shortlisted candidates will be conducted in Mumbai in all the discipline except geology. So yes, geology branch will be applicable, but geology is not interview of geology will not be in Mumbai. Okay, Hyderabad for the geology student, the interview will be in Hyderabad. Okay, the clear to everyone. For all the other students, the interview will be in Mumbai, but for the geology student, the interview will be in Hyderabad. So who was asking about the geology? Yes, it's Biltu Chatterjee. Yes, geology students are applicable, but geology interview will be the students of geology interview will be in Hyderabad, not in Mumbai. Outstation applicants will be paid a two-way normal AC third tier train fare to attend the selection interview. Okay, so you will be paid AC3 train fare also based on alright. For their registered residential address, but the shortest route or actual fare whichever is less. Probable period of selection interview is during October. So your interview will be in the month of October. Shortlisted candidates will be able to choose an interview slot based on the availability in the September 2021. Alright. Alert by the email as well as SMS will be sent to all the candidates who have been shortlisted for selection interview on the registered email. So you will be given an alert on your email or on your mobile phone through SMS or email. So please check your mail and mobile phones regularly in the month of October. Okay. Candidates are advised to visit the website regularly for update regarding this. It is definitely for the scientist course, Chandu. Why not it is for scientist course? Scientist officer, the post is scientific officer. It is a post of this bar. Okay, final year eligible. Yes, final year are eligible. Final selection of the OCS BGFS 2020 program will be based solely on the performance and selection interview, subjected to medical fitness also. A list of provisionally selected candidates will be displayed on the website in the second week of November. By second week of November, the entire list of the selected candidates will be displayed, and that will be also communicated through mail and SMS. One more important thing, if you talk about the eligibility criteria, many other students were asking about that. The eligibility criteria will be for engineering disciplines, course ME 2021, CS 2022, MT 23 and all these posts, you should be a BE or BTech or BSc engineering or a 5-year integrated MTech with a minimum of 60% aggregate marks in one of the above mentioned 8 disciplines mentioned in table 1. I will show you the table 1 also. And it is also noted that there is no training discipline called nuclear engineering and applicants with degree in nuclear engineering. So if you have a degree in nuclear engineering, then also you can apply for this exam. Alright. Applicants opting to be considered on the basis of GATE score must have a valid GATE score 2020 or 2021. You can apply on the basis of your GATE score 2020 and as well as 2021. On the basis of both the GATE score. Yes, that is a very important point here. that you can apply on the basis of GATE 2020 and 2021 GATE score both. So if you are not having a good GATE score 2021, you can apply for the on the basis of 2020 also. Okay, but you have to apply in the same engineering discipline in which you have given your GATE exam. It's not that you have given your GATE exam in mechanical, you are applying based on engineering sciences. Okay, so you have to apply on the basis of same engineering discipline in which you have written your GATE exam. Those having qualifying degree in branches like aerospace, automobile, automotive, aeronautical, industrial production, reliability, geology, mining, biomedical, electronics, instrument, communication, information technology, master of communication technology, application dye, electrochemical, all these and all these branches are not eligible. These branches are not eligible in this, okay, for this post of scientific officer in the bar. So here is a table which is showing here all the eligible branches. Mechanical branch, ME21 is a code for the all mechanical engineering students. You have to select this code while applying for this exam. Okay, that is ME21. Chemical students have to select the CH2022 codes. Okay, MT23 stands for metallurgy and materials science. And all these branches, okay, this is for those MT. You have to select the code MT23. Electrical engineering students have to select EE24, okay, it is for electrical engineering students. Electronic students have to select the code EC25 for applying for this exam. Computer science students, yes, many of the students who are from computer science, they were asking, sir, whether computer science is eligible for this or not. Yes, computer science is also eligible. And you have to select the code CS26 when you are filling the form. Okay. How the post for EC student? Bharat Kumar, yes, the posts are there for the EC student that is written here. Okay. This time they have given the eligibility post for the EC, electrical, computer science, instrumentation, civil. For all these posts it is given. Alright. I have not displayed this thing from my own. This is I have taken from the brochure, information brochure of the BARC recruitment 2021 only. Okay, so this I have taken from there also. Scheme of the examination will be exactly like the GATE level exam. The examination level, the number, level of question will be like GATE. Okay, it will be online examination. You will be given the options. You have basically you have to fill your option. It will be online. How many posts? See, the number of posts they have not displayed. They have not displayed anything. They have not written anything about the number of posts. Maybe after 1 or 2 days they will also display the number of posts. Okay, right now they have not mentioned. Let's talk about the age limit. Age limit for general category student is 26 year, but till August 1st 2021 you should be at least 26 year. OBC 29, SCST 31. It is the age limit for the students of general category 26, OBC 29, SCST 31, and dependent on those who died in the riots of 1984. The age limit is 31 year, and person domiciled in Kashmir division of Jammu Kashmir, you will be having maximum age of 31 year. Okay, that is the age limit. Application fee will be of ₹500, and that will be for only general and OBC category. Women candidates, candidates belonging to SCST category and dependents on defense personnel killed in action and physically handicapped, they will be not be having any application fee. Okay, that is absolutely free. So the maximum application fee is 500, that is only for general and OBC category students. Candidates awaiting final results may also apply. That is a very important point. Many of the students were asking, sir, is final year students applicable or not? Yes, the final year students are also applicable for the BARC recruitment 2021 for the scientific officer. Okay, so if you are, syllabus will be like for GATE exam only, not like ESE. So for triple EA students are eligible for which post? See, the post is same, Pratik, the post is scientific officer only. Okay, whether you are from, see, these are the 9 eligible branches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, no, only 8 eligible branches. These are the 8 eligible branches which are eligible for from engineering stream. Okay, electronics, computer science, instrumentation, civil, electrical, metallurgical, chemical and mechanical. All right. I will tell you about this. This also test series and course. I will tell you both the things. EWS, they have not mentioned any age limit for EWS. I think they are treating EWS and general category, because EWS also comes in general category only, right? So they have the age limit for general category and EWS will be 26 years. No, GATE is not compulsory. Who is telling you that GATE is compulsory? That is, this recruitment is based on both the methods. You can apply only for online examination, or you can apply only on the basis of GATE score, or you can apply on the basis of both. This recruitment is based on both GATE score without GATE score. Either you can apply for both, either you can apply only on the basis of GATE score, or you can apply on the basis of written examination. But this time you can apply for GATE 2020 and 2021 score both. Okay, it is not that you have to apply for this. You can apply for GATE 2020 and 2021 both. Okay, so if you have a valid GATE score of 2020 and 2021, you can apply on the basis of both. All right. Now coming to this training schools. What are the training schools? Many of the students were asking, sir, where will be getting the training? So training center will be in Bark, Mumbai, and this training center is for these branches, all these engineering disciplines that we have talked about: mechanical, chemical, material, electrical, electronics, computer science. All these training will be in Mumbai. Also, the training center is in Kalpakkam, IGCR Kalpakkam also. Okay. Then Indore also, RRCAT Indore also training can be done. Okay, this training center is only for the electrical, electronics and PH specialization. It is not for the mechanical, civil and other special. It is only for these specialization. Then you have also training center in Hyderabad and AMD Hyderabad, the two training center. One more thing that like I told you that through DGFS you can apply for a 2-year M.Tech, 2-year M.Tech program through the colleges which have linked through the BARC. Okay, so you can also apply for the M.Tech directly, M.Tech program also. So DGFS basically, with the help of DGFS, you can also apply for the M.Tech or specialization in different DGFS institute. Like for mechanical engineering, you can apply for M.Tech based on if you have done your BE or B.Tech or B.Sc. engineering. You can apply in all the college except ICT. I will tell you what is ICT. Chemical engineering students can also apply in all the college except RKL. Applied mechanics student can apply for all the college except M. Civil engineering students can apply for all the college except RKL and ICT. And electrical engineering students can also apply for all the college except G and ICT. So if you want to, same applies for the power, communication, control engineering and electronic and circuit engineer. Okay, if you want to apply for this M.Tech specialization through DGFS, then you can not apply in these colleges. These colleges are not applicable for you. Instrumentation students can not apply in these colleges. Computer science cannot apply in these colleges. Okay, so what are these colleges? B stand for IT Bombay. D stand for IT Delhi, G stand for IT Guwahati, K stand for IT Kanpur, KH stand for IT Kharagpur. So these are the colleges in which you can apply for the M.Tech through DGFS. M stand for IT Madras, R for IT Roorkee, RKL stand for NIT Rourkela, VR stand for IIT BHU of Banaras, ICT stand for Institute of Chemical Technology or ICT Mumbai. Number of DGS fellows selected in each of the approved M.Tech or M chemical specialization at the institute under DGFS will depend upon the recruitment of DAE. Okay, clear everyone? So if you want to do your M.Tech through DGFS entry, you can apply for these colleges. But like for mechanical student cannot apply in ICT. And there is no work in ICT because IT is for Institute of Chemical and Technology, ICT Mumbai. Except that you can apply in IT Bombay, IT Delhi, IT Guwahati, Kanpur, Kharagpur. These are the Roorkee, Banaras. These are the colleges in which you can apply for the M.Tech. Okay, so with the help of this BARC scientific recruitment, you can also apply for the M.Tech. And after the M.Tech, you will be posted as a scientific officer. Haan, M.Tech karne ke baad 100%, dekhiye, M.Tech karne ke baad 100% your job will be there in BARC. Okay, it's only that if you want to do the M.Tech, it's good. If you don't want to do the M.Tech, and during your M.Tech, you will be given a stipend also. During your M.Tech, you will be given a stipend of 55,000. Okay, you will be given a stipend of 55,000 per month during your M.Tech or during the training under OCS. those who will be selected for the OCS, trainee scientific officer, you will be also given a stipend of 55,000 per month. And apart from that, you will also get 18,000 one-time booking allowance. Okay. And also you will be getting a contingency grant of 25,000 to meet the MTech and other for that. All right. So it's up to you whether you want to go for the MTech or you can go for the 1 year PG diploma course. Okay. So that both the choices will be given to you, whether you can go for the MTech. After MTech, you can come back to Bhabha Atomic Research Center. You can join as a scientific officer. Okay. Number of seats have not been declared. Which courses are allowed to pursue in MTech? See, the courses, they have mentioned here the courses. I think the courses have been mentioned here. No, they have not yet mentioned the courses. That, see, all the courses, you can apply for all the courses which are there in IIT Bombay. The number, the college have been mentioned here. You can apply in IIT Bombay, IIT Delhi, IIT Guwahati, Kanpur, Kharagpur, Madras, IIT Roorkee, IIT Rourkela. So colleges have been mentioned here. All right. Civil is also there, I think. Yeah, civil is also there. Civil student can pursue their MTech from all the colleges except RKL and ICT. RKL is NIT Rourkela, except NIT Rourkela and ICT Mumbai. Civil students can pursue MTech from all the colleges. Okay, clear everyone? ISRO notification, see, I am very positive like that, like ESE exam is getting conducted on 18th of July and BARC notification is also out, so very soon we'll also get a notification from ISRO also. Okay, so just wait for a few, maybe 15-20 days. I'm very positive that I think definitely ISRO notification will be out very soon. Okay. Can a 2022 passing or student apply for this? Final year student can apply. If you are in BTech final year, you can apply. Okay. If you are in BTech final year, you can apply. All right. Can you apply for both? Yes. You can apply for both. And they have recommended. They have recommended that if you apply for both, it will be better. If you apply for both the exams, if you have applied for both the exam, it will be better. Now let me take some comments in app. I can see there are so many comments. Very good evening, and I'm very sorry I was not able to see your comments. Mood is saying good evening, good evening. Mood, Abid, can you share some previous year papers? Previous year papers will definitely share, and maybe you will get some previous year paper in the if there are any previous year paper, will definitely get in the GitHub app. How many vacancies? The number of vacancies they have not yet disclosed. Maybe after 1 or 2 days you will get the number of vacancies also. Notification kaha hai? Notification is online. You can search that in online also. You can search that BARC online recruitment for scientific officer 2021. You will get the entire notification. Up to what rank we can accept that student will be called? Sunny, you can say that up to 500 to 600 rank or up to 800 rank you can be called definitely in general category. But it will be good if you apply for both written examination and online exam interview based on GATE score. If you really want to secure your because this written examination is for everyone. Okay, so whether you have got a GATE score or not, so it will be better if you apply for both the options, written examination, interview based on the written examination and based on the GATE score. Work culture, electrical engineering syllabus. See, electrical engineering syllabus will be same. Hi, Jyoti, good evening. It will be same like your GATE exam syllabus. Okay. Yeah, without GATE eligibility, you should be having a BTEC or in BTEC in final. You should be in BTEC final year. How many marks should we get in BAR? We'll definitely tell you the cutoff also. That will definitely, I can tell you that. Any other question? DGFS. In the starting, Komal, I have told you DGFS. DGFS and OCS. These are the two ways you can apply for that. The exam. These are the two ways you can apply for the BARC. It's not you have to apply. These are the two categories. After you clear the exam, these are the two categories of training that is provided in the BARC. One OCS is a 1 year training. Okay, it is a 1 year training and this DGF is a 2 year MTech program. Okay, so OCS and SFS is basically the trainee program. These are the two types of training they provide in that. Okay. Yeah, Amtrak and Trainee both simultaneously. So I think I have told you here that this is a two-year Department of Atomic Energy Graduate Fellowship Scheme for Engineering Graduates and Physics Postgraduate. That is called DGFS. Okay, that is the full form of DGFS. And this is called as 1 year orientation course for engineering graduates and science postgraduate. That is called OCS. Okay, these are the two different things. These are two different types of training they provide. One is OCS, one is called as DGFS. Okay. If you will do OCS, you have to do additional 1 year training. 1 year, you have to do additional 1 year postgraduate diploma in Homi Bhabha National Institute. If you apply for the DGFS, then you have to do your 2 year MTech. Directly, you have to do 2 year MTech. And after you have completed your MTech, after you have completed your training, you have to join back in Bhabha Atomic Research Center as a scientific officer. Okay. And you have to sign a 3 year bond also. Yeah, 3 year bond is also there. For OCS trainee scientific officer, the bond amount is 6,78,000. And for DGFS, it is 13,58,000. Okay. So this bond will be also there. And that bond is for 3 years. All right. And let me tell you some important dates again. I'm just going to end the session. These are the important dates. Please pay attention to that. Last date for application is 7th of August. Application form will start from 12th of July. Last date for submission online application will be 9th of August. Online examination slot booking. Yes, the slot booking for online examination will start from 20th August to 25th of August. Okay. So 9th August is the last date to fill the application form and 20th to 25th August is the last date for the examination slot booking. Is it clear to everyone or not? Training may qualify. Dekhi, after your training, you have to give a written exam also. So you have to crack the written exam. See, that is after that. Right? That is after these procedure, Narendra, that is you are asking about. It is after you create the written examination or interview. Right? Before that, you have to plan for that. अब आप अगर अभी से सोचेंगे कि आप रिटन एग्जाम आफ्टर ट्रेनिंग यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू क्लियर द रिटन एग्जामिनेशन यू डोंट हैव टू बेट दैट नेगेटिव बिफोर द राइटिंग योर रिटन एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ बार बिफोर राइटिंग द एग्जामिनेशन अगर आप पहले से नेगेटिव हो जाएंगे इट विल बिकम नेगेटिव दैट आई विल नॉट बी एबल टू क्लियर द रिटन एग्जामिनेशन आफ्टर द ट्रेनिंग सो यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू क्लियर द रिटन एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ बार फर्स्ट लेट मी टेल यू विद दिस अप्रोच फर्स्टली यू हैव टू बी पॉजिटिव दैट यू हैव टू क्लियर द रिटन एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ बार You have to apply, you have to get selected in that. After that, we'll see about the training also. Training. Now, let me tell you some important information before we wind up the session. I have told you the important dates, all the important dates and everything I have told you already. These are the stages of online application. First stage for online application is the candidates need to choose the applied discipline and qualifying degree. Also, you have to enter details like name, mother's name, date of birth, email ID, mobile number, and you have to create a unique login ID and password. And these credentials will be used to proceed to the next stage. So you have to give a unique login ID and password. After that, you have to activate that. After completion of primary stage, an OTP will be sent to candidate registered mobile number, and an activation link will be sent to registered email ID. All right. And based on that OTP, you have to log in the portal and you have to start filling the application form. After that, you have to fill the personal information. Personal information will like you have to tell your category, address, photo and signature. You have to upload your photograph and signature also. After that, you have to select your academic information also. You have to fill your academic details, 10th, 12th and relevant degree and details and all the additional qualification. And after step number 5 will be screening information. After completion of academic information, candidates can proceed to the next stage where he or she can choose the channel through which he would prefer to consider it, online examination or GATE. A candidate can opt for both the channels. So that is a very, very important stage. The last stage of the application form will be your selection, whether you want to be considered. See, there is one application form, whether you want to apply through online, direct based on your GATE score or based on your written examination or both. You don't have to fill two application forms for that separately. Okay, is it clear to everyone? So you will be given a choice in the step number 5 whether you want to Narendra, see, these training and other stuff you will understand after later on when you get select. Okay, you don't have to get a clarity about that right now. This is a beginning stage. Firstly, try to just fill the application form, prepare for the exam. That is the first stage you should do right now. All the other things I have told you, that is additional information. I think that information is not needed at this point of time. Okay, still I have shared you that training and program, but that is not required at this point of time. That is just a little bit extra information I have shared with you. Okay, first step that you should do is fill the application form, prepare for the examination, because examination will be in the month of September. Okay, interview will be in the month of October. So first step should be preparation for the exam. If you will not be able to clear the exam, how you will be getting the training? That is a secondary thing. Okay, please tell 7th semester student eligible. I have told you that final year students are eligible. Final year students in 7th semester are eligible. Okay, you are eligible. Clear? Himanshu bhai, aap pe depend karta hai na, aapko Microsoft pasand to aap Microsoft mein jaiye. Microsoft is a private company, BARC is a central government organization. You will be a scientific officer in the BARC. In Microsoft, you will be software engineer, right? So you have to think what is your requirement, what you want in your life. It is totally your choice. In the last stage screening information, in this stage the candidates also can furnish his examination center choice. You have to also fill the examination center choice. If the candidate has chosen the gate as the screening channel, he has to enter the gate score and upload his score while card while applying. Okay. Age limit I have shared, it is age limit is 26 for general category, and it is age limit is 29 for OBC, FCST 31 years. Alright. And very important note is given here, if the candidate enters his gate score wrongly, he may not be shortlisted based on the gate screening channel. In gate score column, candidate has to enter his score out of 1000. If you fill your incorrect gate score, you will not be shortlisted. That is a very, very important thing. Are you getting this or not? No, mechatronics branch is not eligible. Mechatronics branch is not eligible for the BARC exam. See, Himanshu, I have already told you, and that is not my perspective, that should be your perspective. Okay, that is your life, your choice. Payment methods, you have, then after that, after this stage, you have to go for the payment method, right? After that, you have to do the final submission. Once all the other stages are complete, candidate has to make the final submission to complete the registration. All right. That is all these steps. Now, one important thing, that grade up will be starting a grade up will start a course for BARC written examination. Will be starting a course for BARC written examination very soon. So guys, those who are thinking that how are we going to clear the written examination of BARC, GradeUp will be starting a BARC written examination course also. Is BARC worthy for the CSE? Yes, why not? It is worthy. You have to be worthy yourself. BARC is not worthy for CSE student. You have to, CSE students have to make themselves understand whether they are worthy for the BARC or not. Okay. Worthy kya hota? You will be a scientific officer in the BARC. What other things you want in your life? A computer science student can become a software engineer in the Microsoft or Google. That is a private job. But if you want to become a scientific officer in the central government organization BARC, then it's different choice. That totally your different ideology. That is totally different choice. What you want in your life? Final year MSc electronics students are eligible. No, physics students course in the grade up. Right now there are no courses for that. Sir, final year MSc electronics. Final year MSc. No. Only BSc in engineering, BTech engineering, or B in engineering are eligible. Not MSc in engineering. Clear, everyone? So that is all the information. If you are having any other queries, so this is a very important thing, that GradeUp will be starting a paid course a very paid the paid course or a course that may be a crash course kind of course for the written examination of the bar. So my advice for all of you is this course will be for all the branches, for mechanical, electrical, electronics, maybe for all the branches. Okay. One important information I want to share with everyone. My advice is to fill based on the GATE score as well as based on your written examination. Because once, if let's say you are not selected based on your GATE score, at least you will be having second option available with you, right? On the basis of written examination. Clear? And please note down the important dates. Important dates are important. That what is the last date for filling the application form, that is also very, very important. 9th of August is the last date for filling application form. And 25th of August onwards, you have to fill the examination city. Okay? So these are the courses right now at GATEUP. We have Vision 2022 English course for GATE and ESE 2022 exam preparation. We have Vision 2022 Hindi course for GATE and ESE 2022 exam preparation. And also we have a course for GATE and ESE 2023. Those who are interested for preparation with GATEUP, for GATE and ESE 2023, we have also course for that. So for more information, you can also give a call on this number given at the end. Regarding this is a number on which you can call if you are having any query regarding our paid courses. Okay. These are the list of the students who have got selected in All India Rank 10 in the GATE 2021 exam results. Okay. With GATEUP Super, you get access to our structure like course in GATEUP GCAT. So you can also take GATEUP Super now and you can get benefited with these two important things. Okay. So that is all the important things about this session. And my advice is to start filling the application form soon as possible. Okay. And also very important thing is that start preparing for the written examination of the bar. The level of the question will be exactly like the GATE exam. Okay. So you have to just do one thing, revise and practice the previous year question of GATE. Do revision of GATE exam syllabus and practice of previous year question of GATE. Okay. It is my advice right now, because your examination will be in September. You don't have that much time left now. So we can say today is 11th of July. So you have got good plenty of time for revision and practice. Okay. Also, GATEUP will be providing you paid course if you want a paid course for that. We'll be providing your paid course also very soon. So that is all in this session. I hope you have liked the information that I have shared with you in this session. Any other query? What about branch wise vacancy? The branch wise vacancy have not been shared yet, my dear. So maybe very soon they will be sharing the branch wise vacancy also. In which month BARC notification will be given? Sandhya, BARC notification is out. I am sharing with the BARC notification only. Okay, that is already shared with you. Okay, so start filling the application from tomorrow onwards, from 12th of July. Okay. Yes, Swati, what is your question? After completion, six semester? No. After completion of the sixth semester, if you are in BTech third year, simply we can say you cannot give the written examination of BARC. Okay. Written examination of the BARC is only for the final year students who are waiting for their results. Yes, computer science students are eligible. They are eligible. How much is the examination fee? 500 rupees. Only for general and OBC candidates, but for the SCST and female candidates, there is no application fee. All right. Yes. What is your question, SR? What is your question? When is the exam? Exam will be conducted in the month of September. Okay. Application form will start from tomorrow onwards and exam will be conducted in the month of September. Interview will be in the month of October. Result will be announced in the month of November. Okay. In the beginning of the session, I have shared everything. If you are late in this session, you can see the recorded video. And I will also share the PDF of this session. I will share the PDF of this session in my personal Telegram also, Mechanical by Vikas Madhoria. That is my personal Telegram. Also, I will share this PDF in the official Telegram of GATEUP, that is GATE GATEUP. This is the official Telegram channel of GATEUP. Okay. In this Telegram channel, I will share the PDF also. Okay, those who have missed the starting of the session, you can see the PDF. So PDF will be shared here. Clear everyone? I will share the PDF here. Any other information you need regarding this? Expected vacancies have not been released yet. CSC is eligible. I have told everyone, Durgesh, Sandeep. Computer science students are also eligible for the written examination. Okay. Computer science, electrical, electronics, instrumentation, civil, mechanical, all the branches are eligible. Okay. The number of vacancies have not been disclosed yet. So let's wind up the session, and if you are having any other query, you can just let me know. Otherwise, we are just going to wind up the session. Those who have liked the information given the session, you can also like the session and share the session, my dear student. Thank you so much. Take care. Have a nice day. And do not forget to start filling the application form. And also, you can start preparing for the examination, because exam will be in the month of September. Okay. So thank you so much. See, I cannot give you a number right now, because that depends how many vacancies can be there. But yeah, I can say yes, obviously 100 vacancies, up to 100 vacancy will be there definitely for all the branches. Okay. So thank you so much. Mechanical engineering without gate exam. Venkatesh, obviously this is with or without gate exam, both. It is not for only for, it is for with gate exam and based on a gate score and based on without gate score. You can apply based on both. And you can apply on the basis of both the basis, that is gate and on the basis of gate score as well as for written examination. So thank you so much. Have a nice day. Yes, without gate also you can apply. If you see, there is no additional fee if you want to select. If you want to select both, see, if you are having good gate score, you can apply based on gate score as well as written also. Okay. But if a student has applied only on the basis of gate score, then that student cannot give the written examination. Only that student will be allowed to give the written examination who have selected the written examination or both gate and written examination. If you have selected only on the basis of gate score, you will not be allowed to give the written examination. So better will be to select both the options for the safer side. Okay, clear everyone? So thank you so much. Have a nice day. Take care. Thank you so much. And if you have liked the session, please do not forget to like and share the session, and also subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. Thank you everyone. Take care. Have a nice day. Krishna is ESC. Yeah, ESC. How ESC student can write the CS exam? Krishna, no, you have to write the examination based on your engineering discipline in which you have done your BTech. Okay, thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye. Thank you, everyone.